Hello and welcome back. We are in lesson 18 where we're talking about the solution sets to general linear systems problems. Let's do a quick recall of the general linear system problem statement. We start with two positive integers, m and n, which are going to define the dimensions of a matrix. We suppose that A is an m row and n column rectangular matrix that is given. Given means we've spent days, months, or years constructing it from a real-world modeling context. Similarly, we are given a vector B that has m rows. The general linear systems problem is to find all unknown solutions x with n entries such that A times x equals b. In this lesson, what we're going to do is study the template, the form that complete solutions take to the A times X equal B problem. Every solution, anytime I'm faced with a linear system in the form A times X equal B, a complete solution to that problem will always take the form. The complete solution is a particular solution highlighted in blue plus a trivial solution to the homogeneous linear system problem, aka something that sends the matrix to zero. Here you see the notation is kind of creative in the way that I'm saying any solution is a sum of a p-p-p-p-particular solution, that's why I put a p there, plus a z-z-z-z-zero solution, that's why I put a z there. So, what do the solutions look like to any linear systems? A particular solution plus a zero solution. We give each of those component pieces to the complete solution a very specific name. The vector p we call a particular solution, which means when I multiply p by the matrix A, I get back to the given right-hand side. So p for sure solves my original problem. The interesting thing about the adjective complete is p might not be the only vector that solves that problem. Thus, we need to track vectors that send the matrix to zero. Mathematicians can't help themselves. Can't call those zero vectors because, formally speaking, they don't have to be zero. So they introduce this notation called z is the trivial solution to the homogeneous linear system. So when you're looking at a complete solution, we say that it's a particular solution plus the trivial solution to the homogeneous linear system problem associated with the matrix A. There's a bunch of formal language that we're going to dissect later in this lesson, but remember, in order to completely describe the solution to a linear systems problem, every solution is going to take this form, a particular solution plus a zero solution to that system. Before we dive into some examples to show that you already actually know this, let's go ahead and take a look at what this means. So remember, a particular solution, the whole idea of a particular solution is it solves the linear systems problem. So A times P is for sure equal to B. A times P is for sure equal to B. And then the whole idea of a trivial solution or a z-z-z-zero solution, Z, A times Z will get sent to zero. The reason this works for determining a template for the general solution is remember that in matrix multiplication over a vector sum, we can actually pass that matrix to each individual vector. That's called left distributivity of matrix multiplication over vector addition. And then remember, what did it mean to be a particular solution? It meant A times P equals B. What did it mean to be a zero solution, a trivial solution? It meant A times Z equals zero. One of the really sexy and fun things about zero is when I add zero to any vector, I get back to the same vector, which means if I take this solution under the assumption that this is a particular solution and this gets sent to zero, I get back to B. That means that this solution solves my original system. That is why we do this. Let's take a look at some examples that show that you already actually know this in your gut. You just haven't necessarily put words to it. In this class, we're looking at matrix vector multiplication problems with a known output, but I want to claim that you've actually seen this type of operation before in your previous life. Imagine instead of a matrix, we have what we call a differential operator. Imagine instead of a right-hand side vector, we have what we call a known function, and then I want to know if I hit a unknown function with a known differential operator and I produce a known function, what type of inputs could I put into this operator in order to get that known function? Okay, blah, 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 blah. What the hell is this guy saying? Let's look at that problem. This is a differential operator. It's called the single variable derivative or ordinary derivative. If I hit a function with a derivative and I have a known function out, the question is, well, what is that inner function? Still too abstract. Let's go specific. Imagine I'm looking at the following problem. I want to take a derivative of some unknown function and I want to produce a known right-hand side vector. That's like A times X equal B, except in this case, instead of a matrix, it's an operator. Instead of an M by one vector, it's a function. This problem we've seen in our previous lives in calculus, we could rewrite that problem as an integral problem. We're gonna have to fire some of those neurons that we worked so hard to train in calculus, but check this out. The antiderivative of x squared, in general, is gonna be x cubed divided by 3, a particular solution to that antiderivative problem, plus any constant c. And the reason that we do that is the particular solution, if I differentiate that particular solution, I get back to x squared. If I differentiate the constant, I get to 0. It's a particular plus 0. In the parlance of linear algebra, we'd call that a particular solution and this a trivial solution to the corresponding homogeneous linear system problem. Remember in this example, the matrix A is represented by the differential operator. The vector x is represented by an unknown function, and the known right-hand side vector, b, is represented by the known function x squared. And then we said the reason that x cubed over 3 was a particular solution is if I hit that vector, if I hit this thing with my matrix, I get the exact b on the right-hand side. That was the definition of a particular solution. If I hit the particular solution with my matrix, I get the exact b that I expect. The reason we call this a trivial solution or a zero solution is if I hit this solution with my matrix, I get back to 0. The derivative of a constant is 0. That's the definition of a trivial solution. When I hit my zero solution with the matrix A, I get to 0, which means when I sum b plus 0, there's no cost in the output of adding z in the input. See, I told you know this stuff already. When you work hard and you study with your full focus, you become genius. I love it. Let's go on to a second example where we're looking at the complete solution to a linear systems problem as taking the form particular solution plus something that gets sent to 0. Trivial solution to a homogeneous linear system. In this case, we'll think about a special matrix and a special right-hand side vector that doesn't take a lot of analysis. Specifically, we'll look at the 1 by 2 matrix. It's a row vector, 1, 0. And then we'll multiply that matrix by the vector x1, x2. That's a 2 by 1. So 1 by 2 times 2 by 1, inner dimensions must agree. Those cancel out, and I'm left by 1 by 1. Known right-hand side vector, 8. So the question is, what values of x1 and x2 can I use to produce 8? I know you've been working really hard and you recognize 1 times x1, 0 times x2 gives that linear combination of the columns. In this case, the column is a single number and that's a different number. And then the output is 8, but 0 times x2, that whole thing is annihilated. It doesn't matter what x2 is. X2 could be 5, it could be 30, it could be negative 4. X2 has an entire free range. It's a free variable in that way. X1 does matter because 1 times x1 is just x1. And notice, x1 has to be 8 in order to solve this. X2, to repeat, can be anything, which means we kind of have this understanding that any solution to this linear systems problem would look like 8 in the first entry and any x2 in the second entry, but we can now split those into two and say, hey, 8 comma 0, we're gonna call that our particular solution, and 0 comma x2, we're gonna call that the thing that gets sent to 0 under our map, aka the trivial solution. And that kind of checks out, right? Because if I take 8 comma 0, 8 comma 0 times 1, 0 on the left-hand side, 1 times 8 is 8, 0 times 0 is 0, 8 plus 0 is indeed 8, so that thing is a particular solution. And then if I take 0 comma x2, 0 comma x2, 1 times 0 is 0, 0 times x2, doesn't matter what x2 is, goes to 0, 8 plus 0 is indeed 8. And we come back to that really beautiful structure. Any solution to a linear systems problem is going to be written as a particular solution plus a trivial solution to the homogeneous linear systems problem involving the matrix A. Another way to say that is something that gets sent to zero when multiplied by A. That's why I call it Z. When looking for the complete solution to AX equal B, when looking for all X values that solve that, those X's are going to look like a sum P plus Z. P is called a particular solution. When I multiply A by P, I get the exact B that I started with on the right-hand side. Z is called a trivial solution to a homogeneous linear systems problem involving the matrix A, which means A sends Z to zero. In this case, we've seen this template come alive in an example that you already know because you're hard workers and you've been studying math really, really diligently. And an example that you can figure out quite easily when you're generating intuition about these ideas, come back to these two examples as a place to hang your hat. In the next video, we'll explore using this general form on a specific example that we saw in lesson 17. I'll see you in the next video.